volante.
You know, I hate to be that guy, but I thought Mad Max would be a lot madder than this. Like, I was expecting Rage Against the Machine to be playing and some guy with a permanently furrowed brow.
Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me! Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me!
I'd say he's slightly perturbed Max for the first 85% of the game, and then he turns into mildly upset Max for about the last 20 minutes. That's a little bit more accurate. If I'm just being straight up with you, this game is basically a 19-hour episode of Pimp My Ride, where you roam around the desert wasteland killing people, blowing things up, blowing bigger things up, blowing things up with your car, and actually, all you'll be doing is blowing things up. But don't think you have to do it all by yourself. Joining you on your journey is your trusty sidekick, Chum Bucket, who can add a ton of different upgrades to your vehicle and is basically the world's greatest mechanic.
It is me, Chum Bucket, Master Wrench Jockey.
Whether you want to completely rice out your ride, and I'm talking straight rice-a-roni, or you want to make it as fast as possible, he's the one that will do it for you. Now, the only four things that you need to collect in this massive desert wasteland that Max likes to call the Plains of Silence are gas, food, water, and scrap. Gas can be used to either fuel your vehicle or blow things up. And 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, 4-1000, 5- Oh, fuck! Food and water give you health. Just keep in mind the only two items on the menu are dog food and maggots. So it doesn't really matter what you're eating because it all tastes like merde. And scrap metal is money. Thank you for not making things unnecessarily complicated. But I must say, it gets a little silly after a while with the whole concept of chugging water for health, especially during boss battles like this guy's about to smash your face in with a giant piece of metal, and you're just calmly drinking water? I ain't even mad, Max. I'm just kind of puzzled. Now, getting gas, food, and water is the easy part. Getting your hands on mass amounts of scrap metal, on the other hand, is not. But all you gotta do is help out the people of the wasteland. They'll hook you up with all kinds of scrap metal if you help weaken the influence of Scabrous Scrotus, the main villain in the game. I don't know why they made his name close to scrotum, but whatever. All you need to do is blow things up and raid camps. And raiding enemy camps is the bread and butter of this game. Not only is it a blast, but it's also how you progress, so pay attention. The first thing you gotta do is get rid of the perimeter, and I don't know what the deal is with these enemies, but anything that they see moving around, they like to light on fire. So basically, take out anything that is trying to light you on fire and then bust through the front gate. Pretty simple. And just so we're clear, 90% of your problems in this game can be solved with a harpoon. It doesn't matter if it's a structure or a vehicle or a sniper, but I will say, but, just to pump the brakes here, don't get too carried away with the ragdoll, because sometimes if you whip and nay-nay a guy all the way around so hard, it can almost crash your game. Like, I had massive frame drops with this one guy. I don't know what happened. Now, once you're inside, the first guy you always gotta kill is the War Crier. He's like a boombox in a high school football locker room, and then he gets all these crazy enemies super hyped to tear you in half, so if you take him out first, you cut off their motivation, and they're pretty easy to kill, dismember, destroy, and I guess because this is Mad Max, light on fire. That seems like the solution to everything. Now, sometimes it's fun to make it awkward for him just by killing him last.
Just me left. But you see, I'm not, there really is no Please just don't kill me.
I don't think so.
But other times, he starts yelling at you so much that you just have to murder him. Like, come on, man. Why are you yelling at me like this?
I don't want to talk to you no more, you empty-headed animal food trough whopper. I fart in your general direction. Your mother was...
Once he's out of the way, you get to beat every last enemy to a pulp via one of those modern combat systems. You know what I'm talking about, right? It's basically mash this button until we tell you to mash that button, and you're basically invincible unless you have brain damage or the reaction speed of Charles Barkley. Not that I'm complaining. I mean, I have no problem with it, but it's not like combat is necessarily difficult. Like, you literally need to press attack, block, or dodge, and you'll slaughter your enemies worse than when Godzilla dunked on Japan. The real fun starts when you throw their elements into the mix, like Fury or your Super Saiyan ability, where you start hitting harder than Chris Brown, with the added bonus that you can whip out wrestling moves like this is WWE 2K16 and you're John Cena.
Oh my god, Cena! Look at the strength of John Cena! The Lord of the Power! Can Cena have seen?
Get pretty off the rails once you start using melee weapons, because logically, if Max can already dismember people with his bare fists, you better be pretty scared once he gets his hands on a shovel. And once you kill everybody, all you need to do is take the resources and blow up everything that's combustible before you move on to the next camp. Easy peasy. God damn it, Chum Bucket. I said V8, not V6. And just a quick heads up, V6 is trash. V6 is just, ugh. V6 just puts a poor taste in my mouth. It's like one of those dudes that eats hummus with a spoon. Why would you ever want a V6, man? V8. V8.
What did I tell you? V8, not V6.
Beyond that, I must say this game looks wonderful, yet I can't quite put my finger on it as to why. It's not just the desert, it's not just the explosions, it's kind of like that one girl in your life, you know, the one where you can't quite tell exactly what feature you like about her, but you just enjoy looking at her face. That's exactly how I feel about this game. And raiding camps isn't the only fun part of the wasteland. You can also compete in death races, which are pretty boring, unless for some reason they're really close, but when they are really close, they're really fun. You can also take hot air balloon rides if you're into that sort of thing. You can even collect old pictures. I don't know why somebody would just sit there and collect pictures, but hey, I know lots of people that like to collect pictures for no reason at all.
Oh, what the fuck?
And at the end of the day, all you're really doing is blowing things up to get scrap metal so you can upgrade your ride and kill the dude that makes you mad. All right, fine, not mad, mildly upset. Whatever.
Walk into the club like what up? I got a big cock house. Pump the box of shit from a thrift shop. Ice on the fringe is so damn frosty. The people like.